Hey, welcome to the Sex End Show. That's right. It's not a show about penises. I'm sorry if you're disappointed. It's all about Black Series 6-inch figures, Star Wars, and some Marvel Legends. We love these things, and we're going to talk about them and a whole lot more. Some news, a little bit of special features, and some other stuff, customs and toy photography. But let me introduce the guy who's going to join me on this, my co-host Matt. Hello, sir. How are you?
Nice. Good, Stephen. How are you?
I'm good, mate. Thanks for joining again. You were in board conversation recently, and we've been yakking like nothing about toys on text and emails and all sorts of stuff. So it's good. We finally get to talk purely about 6-inch toys. So I'm dead excited. I love this stuff. Look, tell other people just so you know, and we'll show you your channel just here while you're talking. But how did you get started in 6-inch figures, and what's going on with you in terms of Star Wars 6-inch? Where did you all start with this?
Look, I obviously, like everyone, started with the vintage 375 figures. I think for a period of time I was collecting the 12-inch Sideshow collectibles, but really found that they were too focused on the prequel trilogy and lots of Jedi, and yeah, they were too big as well. So I kind of got out of collecting, and when the 6-inch announcement came out, and they were my favorite sized figures from the DC Direct stuff, I was just kind of like, I'm back in. So
And you went
yeah.
back in deep, didn't you? You went you've made 6,000 posts, you got multiple channels on Instagram. I was just looking at them the other day. Actually, you get some great other stuff known, Star Wars too, which we're going to talk about. But this is you
Yeah,
on
so
Instagram.
Star Wars, the Black Series, there's Toy Tribe, I guess there's 1977 as well, and Star Wars 1313.
You're a busy dude,
So,
man, on Instagram. You get a lot going on here, but you're sharing a lot of your stuff as well as a lot of other people's toy photography. And we're going to talk about this regularly on the show, I think, and share a lot of the cool work that you've picked up and curated here. But it's a fine page, sir. A lot of news and a lot of customs, and we're going to talk about Old Boy CTTS, all sorts of stuff. This is beautiful. It is such a good page. I love that picture. That is so good. Anyway. Toy porn is what this is all about. But so you're I mean, just like me, you're really into this stuff. You're into Black Series 6-inch, and that's what we're going to talk about the most is probably Star Wars, with a little bit of Marvel Legends here and there. But what kind of stuff have you been buying recently? Have you been 40th anniversary? You've been buying, we know that.
Yeah, the 40th anniversary, I just off Amazon picked up the Lando and Qui-Gon. Yeah, just trying to get the latest waves. As you know, very hard to get in Australia on any kind of regular basis. So, just trying to keep up to date.
It's hard.
Drooling about comic convention exclusives, but
Tis the season to be penniless. It's the time when we just, yeah, everybody goes nuts for Comic-Con exclusives and all that stuff. And we're going to talk about that. We're going to show some of them tonight. If you haven't seen them before, we'll show you the upcoming Star Wars Hasbro Black Series exclusives for San Diego Comic-Con. We're going to get into a lot of detail in this show, get quite anal about this stuff, and really pick out some of the details and some of the toys and photography and customs and stands and cases and swappable heads, and we got a lot of stuff to talk about. So let's dive right in. Got some news first of all. Let's get right into that. So we'll get some show notes as well. So every show that we've got, we'll put the details in under the description below in the YouTube video, so you can click on all the links. But first up first, one of the things I thought we could talk about is, because it's brand new just in the last few days, is Grey is out already. So damn, this thing's on shelves.
Yeah.
So, and it's here. It's here in Australia for a shocking $50. So, have you got a Toys R Us near you?
Yeah, I do. I've got one about 10 minutes away. I didn't go today, but the $50 price tag just,
No.
it's scalping retail style.
It really is. You're absolutely right. It's a very pricey piece overall. But you're talking for those of you guys in the States and overseas and Britain and other way, to convert it all a little bit, 50 Australian dollars is working at about 40 or 39 US dollars. That's quite a lot. It's nearly 2 for 1 here at the moment. So Toys R Us, as I've said there, and there will be a little bit of swearing on this show, I'm sure, but they really are a shit store, I have to say. I just don't like going to Toys R Us. Are you, Do you like Toys R Us as an experience?
Not really. They're always empty on their shelves. They've got so much junk. But it's the thing that pisses me off is this. You know, I think they did the First Order Snow Trooper exclusive at the same price, regular price as the other figures. Then when the hover tank came out last year, he was, I think, $45, but $40 for the sale when he first came out. They had $5 off in a catalog.
Yeah.
And now for Green to be $50, it's just criminal. But, you know, we've got an option of getting him, but it is honestly, it's cheaper. This is a case where it's cheaper to do it off eBay.
No, it really is, isn't it? It's bizarre how you, Toys R Us, it's not a great company. I mean, we'll probably talk about some more detail at some of the places to buy and stores, but Toys R Us, and we talked about some more conversation anyway, Toys R Us is not in a good financial state. They're in a terrible mess, and their kind of main thing they sell is nappies and strollers, and that's what brings in the money, not necessarily Star Wars, but yeah, it's pretty bad when, geez, oh, $50, it stings, man. Such a good figure as well, but $24 in the US, coming out the 20th of July, so as this recording goes, that's 4 days away from now, and if you're in the US, it's normally about 10 a.m., thanks to Jason at Yakface for kind of pointing out the best time to show up. But Gree was also, you shared, I'm just sharing this on screen as well, you were the first place I saw it actually, where someone had seen it on Canadian shelves.
Yeah.
So yeah, this was, I don't know who the person there was, but Hong, what was that, popping up on Zong King shelves, whatever that is. I don't know what that is. Or was that, no, it must have been Toys R Us.
It's probably some bad typo correction from Hong Kong.
I was going to say Zong King.
Yeah, that's an autocorrect there. I can go in and fix it up after the show so no one will ever see it again.
Hong Kong, peeps. Zong King.
So, yeah, I think it turned up Hong Kong first, and then the next photo I shared, I think, was a Canadian one. But,
Oh, well, okay.
Yeah.
But this, you were saying it was also showing up in Canadian Toys R Us shelves too. So they kind of got it first. It is a gorgeous picture. It's really pretty beautiful in terms of the paint app. So he's going to be popular.
Yeah, I think so. And obviously, too, the thing to look at is the new logo up top. Is another change to the packaging.
Is it?
So it's white.
Oh, yeah.
The other one was a more dull gray or kind of in... the same as what the drawing is the kind of color of the outlining, and now it's a clean white.
Nice, well spotted. A few people, we were talking about this on the Realm Recap, another show we do, and the little antenna that's on Gray's back, a couple of people had thrown the packaging away and didn't realize it was still inside the packaging. So this is a tiny little antenna, so be careful if you've picked it up. But micro binoculars, that is another reason why I think a lot of people buy that, it's for the troops. Giving them little binoculars, but yeah, I want to get these. Got to get them. He looks fab. He looks fab. So he's out. It's coming to the US for those. I have no idea about the UK. We talked about this before. The UK, if you're watching, what's going on with you guys? I'm not hearing anybody get 40th anniversary. I'm not hearing any exclusives. I'm just hearing as if you're getting zip. So we'd love to know what's going on. Tell us what's going on with you guys over there, because it seems... You and I here in Australia and the US are getting stuff pretty readily. We're getting these. They're coming out. But the UK and Europe are just struggling, it seems. But not good. However, just one other link there. And again, all these links we'll put in the show notes. You shared out some work from a very good Instagrammer, Chewy the Pooh. I love that. Chewy the Pooh, whoever you are. That's just an inspired name. That's fantastic. But he's already got his Gree. Really nice picky reshared out there, just a little bit of smoke and the details, and he's right in with the camouflage. He's fitting in perfectly into this little forest scene. So yeah, I've got a funny feeling we're going to see a hell of a lot of these customs on your page as well. A lot of people will be sharing this out, but it's such a cool figure.
I think so. I think it's now becoming the thing at the moment. It's currently dominated my pages by Lando.
Yes,
Lando. Then it's going to be Gree. And then it's, you know,
no.
Always fall back on Stormtroopers. But, you know, at the end of the day, there's always one figure that comes out, and Gree's going to be one of them.
No, that's true. Well, we're just getting some figures. A lot of people still haven't got the 40th anniversary. They've been very hard to find. I think most people are finding the Death Squad Commander and the Jawa. I found loads in a store this week. And shared a picture that was like 8 deep of Death Squad Commanders, around the $38 Australian mark. But you've seen a few in stores. I mean, you've been able to pick up some here and there.
Yeah, I've picked up some from stores. I still don't have my pre-orders, and I keep getting told next month, so we'll wait and see from whomever that may be. But you know, on shelves a couple of weeks ago, I saw some sand people, a C-3PO, a Chewbacca, but mainly Death Squad Commanders and Jawas. Still haven't seen a Stormtrooper life on shelf.
You got one.
I got one. There's more of them up on the Gold Coast, apparently.
So
it's like, I mean, I was 2 days ago, I was at somewhere, I can't remember, maybe Toys R Us or Toy Mate, and it was, again, it was about 8 Death Squad Commanders and 8 Jawas. Actually, I was in a Maya as well, and that was the same, just Death Squad Commanders and Jawas only. Must be missing them by about 2 days.
I know. A lot of guys in the US, again, just on another show today, we were sharing some stuff about the 6-inch across the States, and a lot of places are getting them. A lot of places are getting them, but they're scalped and they're gone, and there's one or two left on the pegs, or they're damaged, or there's no consistency. There's no available to go into the store and just get them off the shelf like a tin of beans. They don't stock them like that. It's very small quantities. But the guys in the States, and again, your mileage may vary because it's up to individual stores and store managers to do it. But one lucky guy in the US who was talking to this week, we'll just call him James B., shared a picture on screen, and it was $1.99 in the US for a Han Solo. How cheap is that? Isn't that just crazy? $1.99. So $18 saved because of $19.
Yeah. And we thought we'd done good when Target released him at $17.99.
I know. So, but a lot of people, even in the States, were like, God damn, that sucks, man. I can't get it. Why can't I get it? And it just, mileage will vary. He was in Texas. And it just, yeah, I try and share it as much as I can on Twitter and stuff if we get people so they can find it where it is. And I think in truth, it's been one of the things, even you and I, as crazy toy collectors, we've even been helping stuff with each other and figures back and forth, because that's one of the things that I don't think a lot of people realize you have to do. You've got to network around to people in the States and people in different countries. I've helped people in the UK get stuff, and they help you. It's just, that's the way it works these days. You gotta help your buddies. So yeah, I wish we got them for $1.99. It's just, oh my goodness. And of course, all the scalpers do, they slap it straight up on Amazon for crazy money. But what are you gonna do? Talking of scalping, oh boy, you managed to get one of these, and I got a couple. Star Wars Celebration exclusive, well, kind of, and then also at Hasbro Toy Shop, is now up to an average kind of price, $230 on Fleabee. So I don't think you definitely didn't pay that much, that's for sure.
No. I had a big shout out to my mate Colin in the States, who got one from Hasbro Toy Shop and he sold it to me for cost. So good apart from shipping, Colin was a good friend in that instance, and looked after me, which was great.
Absolutely. This is why you need mates. I mean, they're averaging auctions. There you go. $230 is a kind of average price. Some with shipping, $250. I mean, that's just bananas. B-A-N-N-A-S.
$700 or best offer. I mean,
well, it is graded, but $700. Wow, it's the power of exclusives. And this is a repacked figure on a not really personally, I think, that great a card, because it's so reflective I can't see it. But it's nuts. We'll go back to the very beginning of Black Series, talk a little bit about its history and where they all started, and Matt and I will reminisce about our collections and what we thought about them in another show. But yeah, it's even driven the original look up in price as well. So, oh man, trying to collect this stuff, it's like, it's getting to Lego stakes here in terms of prices of stuff. It's crazy. What else we got? So we talked about Luke, some other stuff that's coming up in terms of pre-orders. Now there's a store here, we're just plugging them. I buy some stuff from them, but we're plugging them because they have a listing available. He's now out of stock of it, but if you were quick enough, they had the Ray Speeder up for pre-order. She'll be going up for pre-order probably just after San Diego Comic-Con, I would imagine. Sometime July, August, at least, anyway, she should be for Force Friday. But did you get in order this, or are you just going to wait and see what's...
I'm gonna wait on Ray. I want to see it, this one. To be honest, I thought it was a great announcement, but I want to watch it. The Land Speeder and Thrawn are my focus at this point in time. Budgetary.
No, you're right. You got to be a little bit picky with it. I mean, it is expensive, and but this just looks fantastic. Kind of the Ray I think we wanted at the beginning with all the accoutrement, all the bits and pieces, but she's got her soft goods cape and the backpack and all the detail, and that headgear looks fantastic. I thought in some ways they've reused some parts of Ray, but I think we're obviously getting some new parts there, but we've got a little cloth bag and all the junk that's in the junk in our trunk. That came out wrong, but never mind. And a little staff, which is different painted colors, I believe, as well. And this stand, which looks really, really cool. So yeah, I'm looking forward to this one. So I could not wait. I had to wait in for this one. So very nicely done. Nice little details in the engine. I love that little blast of air or whatever they've got going underneath as the stand. But yeah, I'm all in on this lane, I think. So I'm just a sucker. I'm just like, sell a kidney, whatever. I'm just kidding.
Look, I really like the small format vehicles. And I think that anything that's small format that they can do, they should be doing.
I know. The TIE Fighter was, now you didn't get the TIE Fighter from.
No.
Yeah, it's just, I mean, it would be great. I see a lot of people managed to pick it up. I posted a link a few weeks ago and a lot of people went nuts for it because it was $55. In the US for the TIE Fighter, which is just insane considering how much it cost originally. But yeah, smaller vehicles. I don't know a lot of people that can store a huge ass TIE Fighter. It's just way, way too big. But yeah, right, small form. Which we're getting. We're getting that in terms of Land Speeder and other stuff. So we'll come back and talk about the Land Speeder and the SDCC stuff shortly. But some other stuff that's offer pre-order on this site. They do ship to the US and Canada and the UK, so if you want to, you can go in there and check them out. But this will be available in all sorts of other stores coming up soon. What do you think of these, sir? These diorama display pieces? I don't think we really talked about this. What do you think?
Yeah, look, I don't like this Luke one, to be honest. I don't mind it, but I don't quite understand it, to be honest. The Darth Vader one, I can appreciate more, and the stormtroopers can go on it and everything else. This one just seems a little bit strange, but you know, horses for courses.
I know. Well, I think it's one of those things. I need to see it. I need to see it or see a review and see it up a little bit closer. Steve Evans and the Posse have done a very nice job. I mean, it looks as a beautiful standalone piece on its own. I think that was the kind of objective, was it could just be a piece on its own, or in this case, you could plug in your snowtroopers, which a little rumor tells us that they might be repacking and bringing back out soon. So if you missed it, you'll get a chance to get him, although he's pretty widely available. But we've got a nice base there. You've got the AT-AT foot and the light-up display, and you can pop in your little snowtroopers into little slots there. But yeah, I think like you, the look looks great, but I just don't know. I need to see it. But
yeah, look, it would have been great for it to be an accessory with another chance or opportunity to buy the Black Series Luke.
That's a good point.
You know, I like the idea and the concept of the diorama and what can be done with that, but the kind of mixing the statue with the figures doesn't work for me in theory.
Mm. Look, time will tell, I guess. We'll see soon enough, but I think it's had a fairly mixed response, but I think, yeah, again, once people see it, they'll find out. So again, for those that don't know, or a lot of people still don't understand what's going on here, this is a statuesque figure, basically. It's an immovable figure. It's beautifully painted and detailed and stuck on this base. And again, you get light up explosion. And again, what you're supposed to do is then plug in your figures there. So it's not a Luke X-Wing figure as such.
And you'd still would have seen it at Celebration, I guess?
I can't remember if I did. I took so many damn photographs. I can't remember whether I saw it. I don't think we did. I don't think they had it available at that time. I think it was just photographs after the event.
Yeah.
But yeah, there was so much on display. I can't remember. So no, I don't think we did see it other than on the when Steve did his display up on screen. I think that was I believe that was the first time we saw it. But I shall check my photos. The other one, just as you mentioned earlier on, is Darth. And we got a kind of Rogue One-esque Tantive IV New Hope scene where you've got a door being, I guess it's like that. It could well be anywhere else. It could be I don't know. It could be anything, that kind of scene. A door in some Star Wars universe part. But we've got a light-up Vader, a light-up explosion and a kind of doorway lightsaber glow. You obviously can't press buttons in the Star Wars universe to open doors. You have to laser them. Great pain and anguish. But what, you're more keen on this one, you think?
Absolutely. I think, you know, as a standalone little statue, it's a much better statue. It's Vader. It looks cool.
It does. It does look good. I think he's probably going to be the key seller, I think, just being Vader alone. And, of course, add a couple of Stormies. Could easily look quite badass. And there were some photographs around earlier on images with that, and we're going to see tons of them anyway, so hang fire on that. We'll bring you the news every show we do. All right, so that's Vader. Time to, let me just double check my notes. I think we've pretty much covered all of the Star Wars. Now, Marvel Legends is another 6-inch line, the precursor to Star Wars Black Series in some way, because it was around for years, used to be part of the Toy Biz line. You've bought a few. You're not a big Marvel Legends fan, but you've bought some. What do you think of the Marvel Legends line?
Look, I really love them. I kind of commit just to Star Wars with my budget, but at the same time, I'm a sucker for anything Black Spider-Man. So I grabbed him, and I think he's awesome. I also got the Venom to partner with him, and I won a Wolverine in a raffle. Kind of thing in a figure raffle. So they're the guys I've got. I think they're really great, and I have to control myself from not falling down that hole. But I look at them all the time. Like I looked at those Netflix exclusive set.
Yes.
And I thought that, look, they're great. I love the Netflix series. I think the figures look great. But yeah, I'm just trying not to fall into that rabbit hole.
Well, I am. I am a complete toy sleazebag, and I pretty much every legend I'll get. Not a lot of them I keep, I must admit. I do like the Builder figures. I think some of them are really stupendous. Sandman and a few others. Hulkbuster. Oh boy, Hasbro, you had me at Hulkbuster. Both of them, the Australian version and the US version. But they're a pretty addictive line, and I think the... we see a lot of people raise a lot of questions about the similarities in the line and the Builder figures. Why can't we get Star Wars Builder figure? And we will answer that. We'll come back and we'll talk about why lines are different and licensing and costs. And we're going to try and break down a lot of technical detail into the why Hasbro do things a certain way, and case packs and ratios. I really want to get into the nuts and bolts of it. So if someone's watching, you've got a question on it, leave a note. Just leave something, leave a comment, and ask Matt or I something if you want to, and we'll talk about it on the show. But Marvel Legends, yes, I am a bit of a diver inner for that line, I'm afraid. And I bought I picked them up at Dark Side Toys, the Marvel Legends Knights. Have you watched any of them? You've watched some of these Netflix shows, haven't you? No?
I've watched all of them. I've watched all of them.
Favorite one of the lot?
Daredevil.
Daredevil, yeah.
Still the first season. The second season was great too. But I've always been Daredevil, Spider-Man, Batman. They're my three superheroes of choice.
Nice. Well, like you, Netflix Daredevil, I really didn't think it was going to be up to much. And then, wow, completely proved me wrong. I loved the second series. That was fantastic. Elektra was superb. Jessica Jones is an absolute standout show on her own. I think it's one that's really very dark, but fantastic. David Tennant just blew me away in that show. Anyway, and The Punisher too. Blade's a comic version there, as is Bullseye, but I think it's probably one of the finer... waves that we've had in Marvel Legends recently, and I'm not a big fan of the Builder figure, but still looks good. So Yes, I'm slightly poorer, but I picked it up at Rogue Side Toys and a few other bits and pieces. So if you want to pick it up, there's a link in the show notes. And they're available right now. They're up for pre-order. So go grab. Marvel Legends wise, what else would we pick up? I'll just skim through some of these very quickly. Some other stuff. If you're a 6-inch fan like us, then you might like some of these. Walgreens in the US still hasn't quite got these yet. You're still sitting on some of the Sue from the Fantastic Four figure, the comic version. Just doesn't do it for me, but you think this would do it for you, Johnny Storm? Pass?
Yeah, it's a pass for me.
Yeah, it's a pass for me too. It's there's a lot of repainty figures, a lot of just no kind of detail on it, and I think that's an easy one for them to do. So yeah, this doesn't do it for me. But that's a Walgreens exclusive in the US. If you want to pick that up, keep an eye out, or again, the link in the show notes, you can get it to Premium Collectibles. Some other stuff that came out recently. Hasbro sent us along a look at some of the Marvel Legends line for Thor. Now, you've not seen Spider-Man, so we're not going to spoil anything for you. You've seen the Thor trailer, I take it. You've seen the
yes.
What did you think? Excited?
I thought it looks great. I am excited for this Thor film. The last one, not so much. Wasn't that great? But yeah. This one I'm looking forward to. And I also thought, again, the Cate Blanchett figure is such a great sculpt. And the Hulk's great, obviously. But, yep. This is a human sculpt from Hasbro. I can only hope it's of signs of what to expect from our last Jedi figures.
I know. I think that we'll talk about this again. I think we briefly talked about it in the Bowen conversation. I know we're sure we did. The scanning, the facial likeness, you, me, and Jesse were talking about it. The Cate Blanchett in that picture is just, wow. I mean, I'm trying to share it on screen here if you can see it, but that's pretty damn good for like something that's less than an inch in height. It's a phenomenal sculpt, I think. They've done a really, really good job. Got to be a lot of people buying that just for that head alone. But beautiful detail and just all the texture. They are knocking it out the park these days in terms of some of the quality of figures. The Netflix wave and this, just very, very impressed with what Hasbro are doing. So there's a little bit closer look at some of the figures. We'll just skim through these, but we posted these a while ago, but I just thought I'd include them for 6-inchness to cover it all round. Loki, again, pretty good likeness for Tom Hiddleston, I thought. Looking a little bit sunken eyes there, though. If you watch Rick and Morty, it's a little shrunken bit there, but it's still him, that's for sure. Great job though, some of the detail they've got on it. And he's got his little cape. That's very Tom Hiddleston, actually.
That is.
It's just very well done with his mullet. A man with the mullet. Can't wait to see that. Bring it on. There's a two-pack as well with Valkyrie and my wife's favorite, Chris Hedroth. So does like a Thor. Maybe is with some effects and Valkyries. That just the quality. That's just straight out the movie. I think the way they've got this scanned or something. So yeah, you're right. I'm just hoping like the Qui-Gon, like Steve Evans was talking about the way they put the embed in the eyes and scanning and stuff. This goes on. We're going to get some stunning figures coming on. But you remember you got a Poe Dameron figure from the Black Series, haven't you?
Yeah. That's the one that I described was Parker from Thunderbirds.
Yes, that's right. He is definitely Parker from the Thunderbirds. Go Google it, people. But yeah, that was one of the moments of the Black Series that I was really like, what's going on here? But then the facial sculpt, as we've seen, I can't remember who it was. This is old stuff now, but the little bit of paint that someone had applied, which is a lot of work and time, which Hasbro just can't do for $20. They nailed it, but they're getting better. Again, here's just another quick look at Chris Hemsworth. Just again, detail is just superb in my mind. Absolutely flawless. And that's some older figures, so we can skip them. So that's it for Marvel Legends, recent ones anyway. Again, if you get something you want to ask a question about Marvel Legends, let us know. One other Marvel Legend just to talk about, I think our last one here. I had to get this Iron Man sleaze bag that I am, but kind of a repaint, retool. We're getting another Spidey from Spider-Man Homecoming. So if you already picked the one up in the main single-carded lane, this is a kind of repack with a slight repaint, maybe getting the paint right this time. And Iron Man 2, the Sentry, which is pretty cool. And there we are in box. with some details. So this is a terrible Spider-Man, I have to say. Did you get any at all from the movie, or no, skipping?
No, I had them in hand and just didn't like them.
Yep.
To be honest, the Spider-Man I'm after is long gone, which is Pizza Spider-Man.
Maybe somebody can help you out. We shall see. This is what buddies are for, man. You can help people out. We'll find one. I'm sure if it wants beer somewhere. So that's us. Let me just check our notes. So that's all of the Marvel Legends and kind of Star Wars news. That was a little bit of a bumper news because we've never done a show before. So two more things to get a look at, and that is San Diego Comic-Con. So two things coming up for San Diego Comic-Con, you know, definitely excited about. But out of the two, and we'll show some pictures here in a sec, which is going to be Thrawn and Luke and the Landspeeder, what one's really your top choice?
I think Thrawn. And it's crazy because, you know, the exclusive is the figure I'm looking forward to. The exclusive is a package.
I know, it's cardboard, isn't it? I know.
But it's great cardboard. And, you know, the little extras are all great as well. So, look, I think Thrawn, we get another shot at Luke, I guess, on general release, as we do with Thrawn. But those little extra features, they're just kind of, yeah.
That cardboard.
Yeah.
Is, and that is a good point. We talked about this again on Board Conversation, that the whole 40th anniversary, you know, I can't remember the quote. I think it was 11 out of 13 figures were all repacks. We were buying it for the cardboard. So I think Hasbro know this, and they're not daft. And they do some great packaging. This is a beautiful piece. I'm not a big fan of fancy schmancy packages, really, because they're a pain in the ass to display. But this one, you're right, is pretty sweet. So we're getting... I can never pronounce these, Yazlamari or whatever you call them, little force, pardon me, creatures. What else do we get? We got the Star Wars Rebels little Hera's kind of family heirloom thing.
Yep.
We got the, and I think this was a little hint from Steve that because it was such a popular character and popular figure, the Jedi Temple Guard, I think what he's hinting away at basically is, like, we've made a mold and we've included and painted the damn thing in the set. And I think you probably agree, we're going to get ready to get one at one point, I think.
Yeah.
So you get Thrawn again. Obviously, he's got a little lightsaber he's collected from someone there. I don't know whether that's someone's particular lightsaber. Jason would know, I'm sure. I think he told me at one point it was. That's a nice little touch. Did you know what that was?
That's, yeah, I've always known that. Indiana Jones's Holy Grail.
Exactly. Isn't that cool? That's so cool. And then we get a Commander Gree helmet, which doesn't look anything like the helmet that we've kind of got. It looks very different, but maybe it's just the paint. But a Gree helmet and another little plinth with, I can't remember what that is actually. We've got another photograph. But you get a lot of stuff in that. You get Thrawn and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 kind of little bits and pieces, and the display is just with the lights. I mean, wow, it's beautiful. It's gonna be a pain in the ass getting this thing in minty condition.
Yeah, that'll be the other problem.
I know. So how are you for are you a real mint on card guy, or are you kind of not too fast? Or
look, I try to be, and as long as it's not as long as it's not ridiculous, then yeah. I'm happy.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, I agree indeed. These are cool. These are, I think, something that you'll probably get to, we'll see a lot on your page.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, all the little bits and pieces, all the little kind of accessories. I'm presuming come off the stand there. So I'm sure we'll see lots of toy photographers having little chalices and things and masks. And these are epic, though. I love these little guys. They look really good. And they look as if they're almost not stuck on. I don't know.
I can't see.
I can't really see. It looks as if they're not quite part of the mold, which would make sense. They're kind of glued on. I love them. I think they look really good. Anyway, Thrawn's going to be epic. I saw him at Celebration in the Flesh, and he was outstanding. They've done another really good job in the eyes. I think it's one of these Qui-Gon sunken eye kind of approaches that they've taken to get the eyes just perfect. So, yes, nice job on that.
I think somebody had said... who they think should play Thrawn in a film, And it doesn't leave me. I think they said John Hamm. And I think that John Hamm would be an excellent Thrawn.
That's a good call. That's a good call. Did you ever get to see Baby Driver? Did you?
No, I haven't seen it yet.
He's, I really wanted you to love it. We were talking about this actually. I was like, I want it to be Shaun of the Dead, but nothing can be Shaun of the Dead. But John Hamm's, he's really good in it. He's pretty impressive. Yeah, that's a good call. John Hamm is really good Thrawn. Very good Thrawn. So Luke, we get another look at Luke. And we get a new head sculpt. And we get a
good
fancy one. I know. The other one just did, well, this is, we're not there yet. I mean, this is just a mock-up, essentially. The other one really was a very pale plastic, but this does look good. What's your thoughts?
Yeah, I think it looks great. I thought, you know, I think, I don't know, I don't want to say too much, but I thought all the Luke sculpt heads have all been pretty good, but the Farm Boy one I was disappointed with. Of the X-Wing pilot, the Stormtrooper Luke, Bespin Luke, and I think that, you know, seeing a good sculpt on Land Speeder Luke gives a reason to grab it.
Mm. I think it's one that's, and I don't know whether we talked about it before, but or maybe you mentioned it to me, but I think the very first figure, the Luke Skywalker X-Wing pilot, still probably has the best, for me, I think the best head sculpt.
Yeah, I agree. I think we did talk about it, yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely one that's, I think, just been really strong. This looks pretty good. I did see one shot at Star Wars Celebration. This was millimeters from my grasp. I was there early in the morning talking to some of the Joe Ninavaji and a few others from Hasbro and Star Wars Celebration, and the case was off. They were just putting it in the case. They were like, okay, calm down. You, I was kind of, oh my god, and have a look at it. And they were laying down the blueprints and the artwork, and it looked beautiful. But when you put that floppy hat on, it kind of didn't work really. I don't know. I think we've always had that problem of the Luke floppy hat just doesn't really, I don't know, unless it's kind of molded on. But so there's two versions of this, and I always get confused what they are. But one has a flap on the land speeder, always with the flaps, and extra weathering. And
so that's the exclusive. The exclusive has the extra weathering and the moving parts in the engine, I believe.
That's right. So we haven't, they've kind of given us kind of odd photographs, whereas this, I believe, is the standard version, which is just it doesn't have a hood, basically. It doesn't have a bonnet, whatever you want to, what country you're from, you want to call it, but it doesn't have that. And no, oh, it still does come with, I think he still comes with these smock thing or whatever you want to call it.
Poncho
look. Looks like exactly the same build, the same fabric. Pretty much everything's the same here. I think we're maybe not getting these macro binoculars. I don't know. But we're getting a land speeder. We're getting a land speeder. That's going to be pretty good. That's going to cause a lot of people to go nuts for another R2 again, to go in the back and another 3PO. And damn it, now I need it.
They're going to have to modify their Ben Kenobi, I think I saw somebody say.
How's that? Oh, yeah, the legs.
Yeah. The legs.
Yeah, that's a good point. It's a good point. Got me a pain in the ass squeezing in, just like the old vintage one. What else we got on this? I think there's one other photograph of Poncho. Here we go. This is the look with his head. The Poncho. It doesn't. See what I mean? I don't know. It's a great design vehicle. There's more flaps at the back, little hidden chests and all sorts of stuff. But yeah, I think that we're going to find that Poncho is going to need some customized. It's not Poncho, sorry. The hat is going to need a little tweaking to get it just right. But
oh, you just don't put it on him. It's not like he wears it in the film.
I know. Cut scene time, I guess. So, yep, it's looking good. So Thrawn is the first one for you. Oh, there we go. Micro binoculars. My apologies. He's definitely got them. So, hell, what am I saying? I'm buying the damn thing. Why am I even debating it? I'm buying it anyway. But he looks huge in that, don't you think?
Yeah.
He looks massive inside. These fly away here. But
somehow R2 and C-3PO have to sit on the back.
I know. Where's 3PO's legs going to go?
Wasn't he sitting backwards?
Was he?
I can't remember.
Maybe those little flaps, maybe we can tuck people's legs inside or something. I don't know. That's a good question. So we're going to find it soon enough. Again, it comes with a little floaty stand, and that's all for the, that's going back into some old photographs. They look good. I'm excited about them. I really am. We're days away from seeing more from Hasbro SDCC. So just to kind of wrap up on the San Diego Comic Con side of things, what do you want to see? What's Matt's top three things you want to see from Hasbro at San Diego Comic Con? I think we already discussed this, but for everybody else, what do you want to see? Vehicle?
Look, I can't remember what vehicle I was saying. Do you remember what vehicle I said?
I think we said AT, both of us said AT-ST.
AT-ST, yeah. I'm hanging for an old man Luke Skywalker. I want my old man Luke.
Everybody wants that, wow.
Yeah. Okay. And, you know, guessing or seeing or waiting to find out whether they're going to do their First Order Stormtrooper and their Jyn Erso kind of Gregory Titus packaged box figure and whether that would be old man Skywalker.
Nice.
So, you know.
Good point.
That's what I'm looking forward to. What I don't think we're going to get, which I'd love to see, is I think that with the Rogue One troopers, the Scarif Stormtroopers, the hover tank pilot, I think Hasbro took a step up in their articulation. I know everyone wants their double jointed arms and all that stuff of the old school figures, but I think they did a pretty good job with posing for the hover tank pilot and the Scarif Stormtrooper. I'd love to see them do another First Order Stormtrooper.
Me, you took the words right out of my... You and I agree on so much stuff. I tried to... I have so many of these Stormtroopers. I tried to get them more articulated at the elbow the other day and snapped. I was like, damn. So, yeah, it's one thing that I moaned about it before at a Hasbro press conference. And I was like, I love this figure, like you, but can't hold a gun for shit, and it drives me nuts.
Yeah, I just think they took major steps forward with Rogue One troopers, and I believe I can't remember seeing something when that first photo came out of the Stormtroopers. They're saying there's some slight difference, and this time in the double dip sense, I'm like, Hasbro, take our money and make the new version with the subtle difference, but give us everything else.
Yes,
like you did with the Rogue One troopers.
I know. Troopers need guns holding, and yeah, they need that. I mean, basically, I think it's, and I've moaned about this in reviews, but they need double jointed elbows, and that's the. I know sometimes aesthetically it kind of can be awkward, but Look, they really do.
I don't know. I agree, and I definitely know that they do. But at the same time, they did do a good job with the hover tank and the Scarif Trooper without the double joints.
I think what
as far as posability goes,
you're absolutely right. You are. I think what they've done, and I mentioned this before, and I can review and talk about it, the way. They just didn't allow enough groove in the design for it to just go up and get a proper 45. It's not really 45. It's a kind of 40-degree angle, and it's just just needs a little bit more, and it would be up enough. God, listen to us getting really eager. But that's what we said we would do here. We were going to do nothing but Star Wars 6-inch, just getting really fussy about stuff. But we love it. So yeah.
What are your three?
My three, I think definitely I would really love to see a small-ish vehicle, although we're really spoiled getting a land speeder right now, but I'd love to see an AT-ST. I really would. And another chance to maybe in that pack, maybe or something, have either a pilot or I would happily buy another Biker Scout with maybe a longer rifle and maybe some tweaks or something. I don't know, a little bit EU-wise, but I'd love to see an AT-ST.
Maybe a snow speeder.
Yeah, Snowspeeder. Could do. But the other one that the figures that I'm really just itching for them to do is I need Dengar. I need the Bounty Hunters. I need them to finish them off. So we always, Fort Elohim and Zuckus are always the last ones to come out. So but Dengar's been really struggling. And I know they've got one and they've confirmed he's coming. So love to see.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, they mentioned before. I mean, look, it stands to reason. One, they've done it 3.75. Two, they've, you know, they're halfway through the Bounty Hunter. So to not do the other ones would be kind of nuts. But they kind of hinted before, so yeah, like, you know, we'll get to him. He's in the parking lot. We're going to do him at some point. When exactly, we don't know. But I think it's got to be soon. I would imagine it's got to be soon-ish. But yeah, that still means Forlorn and Zuckus are going to be, don't know. When? Sometime. So
2020.
Exactly. So we need to finish our bounty hunters. But I think Hasbro know this. They have their allotments and their times and when they're going to do them. And it's definitely hard. And that's something I wanted to talk about as well in other shows is the one thing that always people always say, and I'm sure you get it too, is why can't you make such and such a figure? And I think we need to talk about that in terms of money and tooling and distribution and blah, blah, blah. And, you know, getting things in case of packs and all that kind of stuff.
I do get a couple of angry messages to me sometimes thinking that I'm Hasbro.
Yeah. Make more figures. Yeah. How can I get this figure? I know, it's all these complaints. So, next little portion of the show and the last one, before we kind of wrap this up, but is toy photography. And this is really a lot of the stuff that you've shared, because again, just to kind of highlight on Matt's page, 6,500 posts. He's posted a lot of stuff out there. A mere 93,000 followers. And I love your 666 followers.
Number of the beast.
But some great photography on his site. Definitely, again, there's a link in the show notes to check it out. But I picked it a few. And I wanted to share some. This is when I shared it. I had to share it as well. It just, wow. Trooper Alliance was the guy who shared this pic. Just sharing it on screen. But that utterly atmospheric job that he's done there on, I guess it's a little bit of flour or sugar or something, but do you know what the secret is they use to make these
things? I don't, to be honest. I think, I don't know, I think I probably first saw it with Sergeant Bananas, maybe yeah. The first Hasbro toy pick thing they did 2 years ago at Comic-Con.
Yeah.
And it just keeps getting better. People's techniques keep getting better and better.
Now there is double jointed elbows. Oh, it does have the little ugly plugs, but still makes a difference. Just gives that extra couple of inches. Yeah, it's a cracker photograph. Very well done, Trooper Alliance, from it taking a great photograph there. Some other ones you cheered or I picked out. This is pretty special. That's wow. It just stood out in the entire page as to something. This is it's called Ghost Company. DTG underscore photos, but that's a beauty.
Yeah, some of the customs are incredible, the Trooper customs. This is Ghost Company, I think. I can't remember. There's some that Ollie and Ollie of Flames does where they kind of do troopers that have fallen out of the Empire and become bounty hunters. But the customs are great, and thankfully the great customs usually are done by great photographers as well, so...
Yep.
You know, this is a great recent example of, Ghost Company.
It's nice. It's really, really nice. I like the details and the cloth, and it's all worn and double jointed elbows, dude. Whatever. I like the weapon that he's using. I can't quite place, but it's kind of kick ass. It's huge. I love it. That's a nice thing, I think, with a lot of these photographs that you're sharing out there is people are just reusing bits and pieces and dirt and plants, and I mean there's a lot of people having fun with this stuff, and that's they're playing with their toys, they're having fun with it. But there you go, DTG Photos is even thanking you for making it the feature, so there you go. It's nice to see all this stuff. It's very cool indeed. Some other ones I picked in your channel. Now you got to tell people in the Curb Your Enthusiasm, I know of the show, I've never really watched it.
Larry David,
what's going on here? You're a big fan of the show, I take it.
Oh, look, I love Curb. I think it's one of the greatest shows on TV. And, you know, I think last week they announced that the date for season 9 coming back on October 1st. And then the guys over at Black Series Rebels had obviously commissioned Gregory Titus to make a Larry solo picture. So it was just a fitting post on the day that Curb's announced return was made. They shared it, and you know, I didn't think I'd be able to share a Larry David post on my page, but not only was it a Larry David post, it was a Black Series post. So, you know, it's pretty, pretty, pretty good.
So the artist is Gregory Titus, correct?
Yes, he's the Black Series artist, and sometimes he does commissions, and the Black Series Rebels guys got him to do a Larry solo commission, which he did, and when they shared it, I shared it.
Nice. Well, you're now going to have to get an old Han Solo and get a custom head.
Exactly. We'll get the old boys onto it.
Absolutely. Get the old boy CTTS, and we'll talk about him in another show as well. Very cool indeed. We'll talk about Gregory Titus in another episode as well. But I think one of the last ones, talking of old boy CTTS, if you didn't know who this is a guy, and correct me if I'm wrong, man, a guy from Singapore who does amazing tattoos, designs of all stuff, and custom heads.
Bangkok, I think.
And what?
I think he's from Bangkok.
Bangkok.
Settled out. That's a good show.
He does court. I was like, I don't know about that. Actually, if he does that or not, but that's up to him. This is the 6-inch show, indeed. It's full of innuendo.
So these guys are amazing in their sculpts and customs and paints. Sometimes they just repaint the existing Hasbro sculpt, which they did with Lando most recently. And I think I've got him here. So I'm not sure if...
Yep, I'm sure.
Is he up on their page? No. But in the case of, there you go, the Baze and Charette is both just a repaint of the existing sculpt.
Okay.
We go down to the... Lando? Yeah, I've got Lando with me.
Yeah, go. Oh, shoot. How cool is that? Now, the Hasbro sculpt was good, so all he's done there is basically repainted it, correct?
Repainted it, yeah. So he's done a repaint, and then sometimes they just sculpt from nothing, as they have with Cad Bane and the Grand Moff Tarkin and Donald Trump.
Donald Trump. Oh, my God, I'm not following him. I must follow him. I don't get time to look at Instagram these days. I really should. Hello. Is that a nipple? Oh, dear. There we go.
We're definitely banned from Instagram.
Banned from Instagram. Banned from YouTube. I showed a nipple. Heaven forbid. So there's a that does look good. So he's customized, obviously, the clone trooper there.
Yeah, so they make them when they make them for both Black Series and the SH Figure Arts.
The first thought that came to my head there was a cameo word up. You'll be old enough to remember that cameo word up. That's word a piece first there. He's kind of doing the time warp a little bit to yeah, all right. So custom heads for Game of Thrones. Wow, he's even, I think...
So that was a repaint. They're repaints there.
God, he's nailed the flesh there, hasn't he? He's really got the color of the skin. Those two are very dark skinned in some way. Wow, that's beautiful. What else has he got? Donald Trump. Oh, boy. Let's not see anything about him. Got a smug look, that's for sure. Captain that. Anakin. Let's have a look at that. That's pretty good. It's not bad. Definitely episode 2, Anakin, I think.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, he's done a lot of good stuff, man. Oh, wow, look at the Kylo. Jeez. That just shows you again the repaint, a repainted Kylo. So I think, and again, we've talked about this probably, and we will talk about it to death, but clearly Hasbro are scanning these guys.
Yeah.
But the paint is a huge time factor. And I had a kind of, not an argument, but a bit of back and forth with someone on Twitter, and I'm sure you have on your page, but people were saying, you know, why can't Hasbro do this? It's like, because the figures wouldn't be $20. They'd be $70 yeah. bucks or $80. Or they'd just be, you know, it takes so long to do this, but wow, what a job. What a job. I mean, there's even like little dimples on his cheeks. And
so like, look, I say it when I have these things, and I've got the new hashtag for it, but the sculpt is there.
Yeah, the sculpt is out there. Sounds like a X-Files thing. Yeah, so there's plenty of stuff in old boy CT. Oh my goodness, that's even... Wow. Wow. Head sculpt. So yes, all this stuff that we're talking about is going to be in the show notes below. I could go in here all day. No wonder you love Instagram so much. There's just endless goodies on here. Is that the repaint of the...
Yeah.
It's a repaint of Luke Skywalker. Damn. Just shows you. Yeah, they're really doing a good job with the scanning. Anyway, that's, I think, pretty much the majority of the stuff we have in our notes. Before we go on, anything you want to plug or talk about?
I think, we're 4 days out, 4 or 5 days out from Comic-Con.
Yep.
Looking forward to the reveals and catching up with you to talk about those very reveals. I think on my part, you can find me at Star Wars The Black Series on Instagram or at Toy Tribe as well.
You're on Twitter too, aren't you? You're under, what are you under on Twitter?
What am I? Am I Star Wars TBS?
I can't remember. We'll put a link in the show notes. Just click the links underneath. We'll link to that. Yeah, we're 4 days out from San Diego Comic Con and Funko Pop and the Star Wars Pop and all that stuff, but we're just sticking to 6 inch. So so the next shows coming up are going to be, again, we'll do another one soon, hopefully, for San Diego Comic Con reveals. We'll share all the images when Hasbro share them with us. We'll have photographs. I've got a friend of mine, photographer, who's going to be at the Hasbro panel and some other images. So we should have a lot of goodies fresh in hand. But on this show, I'd love to talk about some stuff, and we've hinted at it before. Stands, customs, sculpts, paints, repaints, Hasbro distribution, why things aren't so good and why figures cost so much and why the case packs and the revisions and all the kind of moans and groans you've got by Hasbro and the good stuff. So if you've got comments, leave a note underneath, ask Matt or I a question, whatever, we'll answer it. We'll try and go through it. Things that you want to see on the show. If you want to do it on Twitter, you can. The hashtag T61S, the 6-inch show. Is kind of free-ish and vacant if you want to use it there. But hopefully we can go back to the beginning and look at some of the original figures and just talk about the stuff we love, and we'll talk about pricing. Some of these figures, is just they've gone nuts in terms of the pricing. And we've got a good 130, if not more, 150 odd Black Series figures once you add them all. That's a lot. So are you fully in on them? I mean, you're missing quite a few still.
Look, I think, and we'll go over this, I've got all the orange, I've got all the blue, I still don't have, I'm missing the Shadow Squadron, I'm missing Han and the Tauntaun.
That's not
bad. And then I've got everything up till then, and then on the Phase 3, I think I'm missing a Hux, obviously the TIE Fighter I didn't do, and yeah, a couple of odd ones here or there.
Yep.
So yeah, pretty much close to complete, but when the red phase came out, I went, I'm not going for fully complete again. If I miss some, I miss some.
Yep. Nope. It's too late for me, my son. I have gone full credit card pain. But there you go. That's what happens. Thank you, dude, so much for hanging out and joining and talking about toys. Always good fun talking with you, but such good fun to finally do this. I've been itching to do this for like a year, trying to do a 6-inch show, but so, so happy. So thank you for joining and sharing all your good stuff.
Well, thank you.
And we'll be back soon. So please leave a comment if you like it, share it, and all that kind of good stuff. And tell your friends if they like 6-inch figures. We're here. We'd love to do more stuff. Let us know what we want to do. And that's it for me. You can find links to all the stuff below, to Matt and myself, and we'll see you again soon.
Thanks.